We at war. We at war with terrorism, racism, and
coffee.
But most of all,
we are live.
What's up, ladies and
Stogies
gents?
Stogies and stuff.
Season two. Hey, episode
now, guys,
32.
Fuck yeah. What I was going to say is, obviously, if it's a new season, we would be like, oh, well, why isn't it episode two instead? No, we're just trying to keep the episodes continued. So it's season two, technically episode two, but 32. there truly is a loss of central values going on right now, man. Oh, in the United States. I mean, look, whether it's part of the growing process or not, to be honest, I haven't been alive long enough. I've only read historically on, you know, the uphills and downhill battles of a nation. But maybe we should just take the Alexander Great approach. And maybe that is what we're doing. You know, essentially just adopting cultures. So it could just be what we're doing, bro. Maybe it's a shift of culture. We don't know.
We'll see.
Bro. Only time will tell, people. Only time will tell if we even live that long enough, right?
Damn, where are we going, bro?
Nuclear war. Anyway, you didn't hear it from me.
I heard it from Mike. Nah, but like, it's true. I mean, shit, we're just all over the place. Men have turned into women. Women turned into men. I don't know who's leading anymore, but we're going to change that shit.
It's biblical times, bro. Biblical times are playing out.
It is biblical. Guys, if you guys think that shit's fake, it's not. All of this has been written already.
It has, guys. You better hope your name is in the book of life. For those of you that understand the reference, you know. If you know, you know. For those of you that don't, pick up the Bible and start reading.
This too shall pass. All right.
So we just did a bunch of fucking... we pulled the Bible verse. Because you know how like a Bible verse can have like... three different references
know,
within it,
like,
and you don't know
like,
unless you read it.
Yep.
We just did that shit right now.
Greatness.
Woo!
But let's step right into it. First
let's
topic,
do it, bro.
It's become a thing, guys.
It has, guys. It's taken over.
We got some good response last podcast, first episode, season two, which is episode 31 of season two and Stogies and stuff. Just throwing that as a reference out there in case you guys want to watch it. But we did our first Cruising Through X, and it was a good success. Reactions towards basically just anything that's being pushed out there, right?
Right.
And so let's start it off with that. I really liked it. It was pretty cool. But first thing that just popped up as we... Let me share my screen. I'm sorry. So sharing the screen as we speak. Patrick Bet David, my man.
Oh, shit.
Take a sip for you, brother. All right, let's see what he's got to say today. It says, madness with Pride Month has to stop. We have Father's Day one day. We have Mother's Day one day. Yet we have, let's expand this. Okay, Bisexual Health Awareness Month. March 31st, International Transgender Day of Visibility. April 6th, Asexuality Day. April 26th, International Lesbian Visibility Day. May 17th, May 19th, Agenda Pride Day. May 22nd, Harvey Milk Day. What the hell is a Harvey Milk Day?
I have no idea.
May
24th, a lot of those I wasn't even aware of.
June, Pride Month, the entire month. Damn, look at all these. It's the whole fucking year. July,
wait.
August, September, October, November.
These are days dedicated... Oh, right
145
there.
Days out of 365 days dedicated to LGBTQ. That's 39.7% of the year.
Make that make sense.
How does that make... Oh, dude, look. Literally, how does that make any sense?
Oh,
meanwhile, we took God from school. We took
prayer
out of school. We stopped saying the Pledge of Allegiance in school because that's offensive. Who's better for a healthy society? Promoting LGBTQ or marriage? Pro-family unit, husband and wives. Damn, he's got a lot of good points.
Mm-hmm.
God bless us all indeed, Patrick. You know... my intake in this is I agree with him. Shit, like, what the fuck is even this? I mean...
Well, yeah, the problem with the man is that whoever's on the background pushing these ideologies clearly is trying to bring the USA down.
Yeah, no
guys,
shit.
Guys, do you understand that, look, at the end of the day, whatever age you are, whatever you want to fucking be, that's on you. Number one, don't push the ideas on people. Especially ones that aren't for the betterment of the society. Because there is nothing, absolutely nothing better out of a society for pushing an ideology like this. You guys are already equal. It's not like anybody fucking, you're not going through what unfortunate minorities went through back then of lynching, being burned alive, unequal rights, you having a drink out of that water fountain versus the other, you sitting in the back of the bus. None of that shit is happening to you. So what the fuck's the point of this? I'll tell you what the point of this is. They're trying to crumble society. What happens when you have a gay couple? They can't have babies. They can't procreate. So what the fuck's the point? Guys, if the U.S. ultimately goes down this rabbit hole, I don't see it lasting past three generations from now. Because we're not going to procreate. The amount of people in the U.S. is not going to go up from people in here. If it goes up, it's going to be of democratic policies like Biden that are allowing millions of individuals into this, into our nation illegally. And it's going to go down as a pot of mess, no longer the USA, just completely with no foundation of underlying policies and done. So you choose, guys. This isn't about politics anymore. This is about people. This is about the future of our loins, the future of society, the legacy. What side are you going to be on?
Yeah, I mean, if this doesn't speak agenda to you guys, and overall, that's our message, breaking down agendas in today's news. I mean, fuck, guys, the proof is in the pudding, right?
Yeah.
145 days dedicated solely to, you know, LGBTQ, you know, the whole movement in itself. I mean, guys, we get it, okay? Like, you guys have a lot of pride, hence Pride Month, right?
But I like what you did there.
You do, I mean... How much more do you need us to give you guys, you know, your peace of mind that, okay, like, you guys have been technically accepted in society, but, you know, don't necessarily make us part of your culture. It's like, we respect it in a way. Now, I'm not saying everybody respects it. You can be, but to a certain extent, everybody's already let you guys initially have, I guess, your say in this, right?
Right.
And so we're not necessarily trying to change your beliefs. We've accepted it, but we're saying don't try and change ours either,
right?
Okay, or influence the kids. That's the biggest thing. I mean, having our nephews, my nephews, Mike, having his kids, you know, his boys. It's like, it's concerning for parents, you know.
Yeah, it is.
You know, as I was checking this out. I mean, apparently other parents feel the exact same way too, because I came across this as well, and I'm gonna show this right here. More parents need to get involved, like this woman. This was just posted on June 7th.
Let's see.
Right, let's check this out. I mean, it's true, you know?
Well, look, first of all, like, what does that flag have to do with anything historically, research-wise?
They're trying to make it a historical thing by saying, hey, you know what, this was, think about it, so they can talk about it 100 years from now.
Right.
Oh, this is why it's right. It happened 100 years ago, and everybody accepted it. And the thing is, it's not at that level. I mean,
no, and even then, all they're going to reference it is this was the downfall of that society.
Exactly. And look, this is a concerned parent. She's telling the teacher straight up, we're paying you to teach history. What the fuck are you doing? I mean, parents aren't even allowed to, kids aren't nowadays in schools, aren't even allowed to sing the Pledge of Allegiance or say any kind of prayers to God or make any references. But of course, it's okay to honor same-sex sexuality practices.
Yeah,
like, what the fuck
it
is
has no
at?
Bearing of anything. Like, guys, I want to make something very clear. I've got nothing against gay people of that community. Nothing, especially if they're kind people, you know. It kind of depends on who you interact with because, you know, I've seen some of those individuals that can be pretty out there. Like, number one, if you're all about that pride parade shit, why the fuck you got to be out there in just underwear or naked?
Yeah.
Like, just protest civilized, you know? Like,
exactly.
You don't got, like, kids don't have to be seeing that shit. What? All you guys prove is that being part of the pride aspect of it is all lust.
That's
like,
exactly
why
right.
Else would you have to be that way? Why That's else right. Would you have to celebrate it that way? Celebrate it like any normal person would.
And please don't get confused or don't mix love and lust as if they're one. You're loving your body. You can love your body in a more respectful manner, right? And then, of course, You know, I've heard a lot of arguments. Well, people should be able to accept the way I love myself. I'm like, yeah, but they should also be able to accept the fact that they don't want to be around the way you're loving yourself either. And you have right. to be okay with that too. It's just respect overall. And the exactly. thing about being an adult is you also have to realize that it's okay for people not to be okay with your, I guess, your certain beliefs or your right. own cultural practices.
Yeah,
it's okay
right.
for them to disagree with you, and you don't have to take offense to that. You know, like, that's the thing about nowadays. Everybody takes offense to everything. People start fucking yelling at each other, screaming,
exactly.
going all haywire, trying to attack, put people in blast on social media. That's the thing now. I mean, you've got conservatives, you've got liberals, conservatives, etc., where they're constantly attacking each other, and no one's really trying to understand each other anymore.
No, they're not. It's become more of an ego position rather than a, you know what, let's stop and think, how can we learn from this to be better?
Exactly.
And you know, guys, what our motto is here.
Be better. So remember, there's objective views and there's subjective views. Subjective
right.
views are strictly opinionated.
Right.
In other words, they're someone's own view on a certain subject.
Right.
Objective views are facts. Am I
wrong? That's exactly right.
Right? Mm-hmm. So facts are, you know what? There's only two genders, male and female. Okay? That's the fact.
Beautiful.
There is
Beautiful.
No such thing as they. There is. I don't know. I mean, there's just so many different labels now.
You're not a
I've
plural. You're one person.
Exactly. So that's an objective view. It's a fact. However, if you want to push about your subjective view, we've already said, okay, you can label yourself in that manner. I'll respect that that's how you label yourself, but that's still not the objective view. The fact is, you're still a man. You're still a woman. If you want to label yourself in that manner, fine. But when it comes to things that matter in regards to, let's bring up women's sports, how that's highly affected, obviously.
Yeah.
If you want to say that you want to compete in women's sports, but generally speaking, when it came to, you know, your anatomy, you're an actual male, and it's just not fair. I mean, you are at a complete advantage over these young women that are working their entire life and their asses very hard. That sounds very bad.
Yeah.
But they're working their ass off, okay? They are working their fucking ass off to get to where they're at just for you
it's
to take
hard.
It like that. But you know what I mean, guys. So
I know exactly what you mean, bro.
Patrick, I guess we can both say we agree with initially what the
yeah.
argument
oh,
that Patrick...
Oh, for sure. And I think he makes a very objective argument.
Exactly.
He's putting facts, guys.
That's all it is.
That's literally what Mo just said. The fact is, those days exist. The fact is, it takes up 39.7% of the year.
That is crazy.
The fact is... people of that fallen cannot procreate.
That is a fact. That is
Sorry.
A fact. So let's keep going. Let's see. What else we got? Robert F. Kennedy.
The ranks of the conspiracy theorists now include the Ninth Circuit Court, which just ruled COVID. Look at that. Oh, shit. They just ruled. So, guys, this is not spreading misinformation. This is a ruling of the court. COVID vax mandates unconstitutional. Because the vaccine does not stop transmission. Now, obviously, this is his opinion of the holding, but he's quoting within there. Experts, Rachel Walensky, our data from the CDC suggests that vaccinated people do not carry the virus, don't get sick. Biden, you won't get COVID if you get these vaccines.
Oh, my God.
Vaccinations.
Fauci.
Fauci's a bitch.
Yeah,
we need
a little
people to take it
I'm
to
sorry,
break
he's
the
a
chain
little
of transmission.
Excuse my language.
I remember I saw this one dude on my Facebook. I don't remember who it was, but he kept fucking kissing his ass. Like, he kept kissing Fauci's ass, dude. Like, oh, Fauci's this and that. And in my mind, I was like, this shit's going to backfire at one point.
Oh,
and it
yeah.
fucking did.
Yeah.
But did. I just can't remember. I'm not calling a friend out. Obviously, if I'm seeing my Facebook, they're a friend. So I'm not calling you out. But sometimes you got to be careful. You got to be prepared to roll with the punches that come.
Yeah.
Obviously, I am a Trump supporter. I'm still in him. There's shit he did that I have to acknowledge. Like, all right, yeah.
But there's some cool memes out there. So, like, I've seen a couple where it's like, did he do it? And even if he did do it,
shit.
You know, like, it's still fine. You know, it's like, we need the man, you know, like, just leave it. It's like, he's already gone a pass from so many African Americans, right? Saying,
oh,
he
no can, shit.
Trump has the... Trump
Holland?
Yeah?
I want to
see it. What did he say?
The UFC fighter?
What did he say?
I forgot his name.
Basically,
Kevin
they
Holland
have the,
or something
they
like that?
They have the pass. He has the pass to say
them.
The N-word.
He's like, I told Trump he's got the pass to say it. I was like, damn.
That's right.
But you know why? He's relatable now. Like, he's, and it's
a,
not just for...
He's a victim, bro.
It's not just for, you know, black people or anything like that. Really what it is, or African-Americans, I honestly don't know. You know, I'm trying to be respectful. So I don't know if it's black people or African-Americans. Regardless, you know what I mean?
However you, however is respectful for
yeah.
you is what we mean it at.
The point is that he is now relatable, guys. And I'll tell you why. 50 Cent, they just asked him the other day, hey, what do you think about the whole situation? Like, why are the black people voting more with Trump? He's like, it's because the artists that I know, they're probably facing RICO charges. In other words, it's relatable.
Yeah, they feel related to him now. It's like, hey, you one of us. Welcome. Welcome to what we've been dealing yeah. with.
You a real.
You a real nigga. Let's go. Ooh. Hey, we're Hispanic, man. We're fucking Mexicans.
We fucking
okay?
say it. You're not going to stop us from saying it. We yeah, minorities too.
Exactly. We played our dues. Oh, look at this. Okay, Ryan Garcia tweeted this 3 months ago. Something bad is going to happen to me on June 8th, 2024.
Wait, what? Why did he tweet that?
Well, look at this right here. Boxer Ryan Garcia arrested for Waldorf.
Click that
story
shit.
Story of vandalism.
Wait. Will it? Yeah, open it on a new link, I guess. That way we don't disturb what's on your Cruising X right now.
Let's just see.
It doesn't let you open new link or whatever?
So this
oh, there
is
you
what
go.
We got right here.
Ryan Garcia arrested for alleged damage to hotel in Beverly Hills.
Boxing star Ryan Garcia. And Ryan, you've been on our pod lately, brother. Let's see what are you up to, bro?
Shit.
Did you do this intentionally? Let's see what you did.
He's 25, bro. He's a fucking kid.
He's a little kid, bro. After Beverly Hills Hotel accused him of causing an estimated $15,000 in damage, the Beverly Hills Police Department commander told ESPN Garcia, 25, was arrested at 5:45 p.m. after a driver who dropped him off at Waldorf phoned the police. According to police, the hotel decided to press charges once police arrived. Though the specific nature of the damage and Garcia's behavior wasn't immediately clear after he was booked at the Beverly Hills Department, police said Garcia complained of a medical issue and was subsequently transferred to
Cedar
medical
Sinai.
Center for evaluation and treatment. Garcia's attorney told ESPN that Garcia might also be charged with public intoxication. Ryan, what are you doing, brother?
No,
Ryan,
not only that. Why would his attorney all say, yeah, he might also face this?
I don't know what the like, strategy. What would the strategy
why
be
would
there,
you
Mike?
Say that?
What would the strategy be there?
There's no strategy to that.
Nah.
You're basically no. There's not. Think about it like this, really quick. I digress, but nonetheless important. That could have been used as a victory strategy. Let's say Garcia did do the vandalism. All right, at least do a horse trade. You know, like well, you know what? Look, I'm gonna take a soft landing approach. Soft landing being, look, the facts are pretty heavy against you for something like this, and it'd be stupid to take it to trial. Let's try to work something out. The working out would be, you know what? I'm going to plead to a PI and dismiss the other charge of vandalism. And then you could have been the hero at the end of the day as the attorney and say, yeah, you know, I got this charge as a PI. As opposed to now, if there was going to be any strategy to that for publicity purposes for the attorney, he's like, hey, you know what? He might also get charged with this. You know what I mean?
You might want to look into it. Because I want to look into this next.
Specifically for your question of, is there any strategy to say that to the public?
Well, that's what
no.
I'm asking. Like,
there's none.
Is there something? That, is there a certain angle?
The only strategy that could have been there would have been for the Chavez attorney, would have been to say, "Yeah, I got this as a PI rather than a vandalism." But no. Anyway, Ryan's been grappling with devastating news regarding his mother's health.
Interesting. Hold on. Trying to exit out this. I think it's the ESPN one that's got my. We'll put pause real quick. Jesse, hold up, Jesse. All right, so let's continue to cruise through X. Let's see what else we're dealing with here.
Start the recording, bro. Oh, I like that.
What's it say? You already got Andrew Tate saying, free my G, Ryan Garcia.
Is it recording?
Yeah, it's recording.
Oh. Free my G.
Let's see. what's Tate doing today?
It says, if you know, you know.
What comments say here? You know. I bought a little bit of a RNT. If you know, you know. If you know, you know.
If you know, you know what? RNT.
Let's check this out.
I think
out.
I know what RNT stands for. He had been saying that for a while.
He's still doing it. What the fuck?
Crypto Inferno.
Let's see, man. Let's see. I think I saw something about Tristan Tate. He put something about this.
See this shit. I knew that's what it stood for. I read right now what RNT stands for.
What it stands for?
Real Nigger Tate.
Oh, he created his own coin.
I'm just reading it there, guys. I'm just reading it right there.
So he created his own coin then.
Yeah, on the
Top
Solana
G
network.
Coin, RNT, Real Nigger Tate. What the fuck? Wow. So that's what it is then.
Yeah.
Stop
I think
tweeting
you started
shit coins
this shit
at me.
Loose coin. Now Cobra Tate is acting like a crypto Deegan, and my Twitter is unusable.
Okay, I think this gets better understanding.
Okay, what does it say? If I understand what Cobra Tate just did, he was gifted free crypto from fans who had made coins. $11 million worth. Instead of selling it for himself, he played Burn Baby Burn on repeat, then burned it all live on Twitter. So he has zero, and the value of everybody else's coins go up. Did I get that right? I think he kind of got it right. I think it's more the opposite, no? Like, he held on to it. He injected value by decreasing the supply, like what we were talking about.
That's right.
And then, obviously, economics, simple economics, the higher the demand, the higher, I mean, the less supply, the more
less
demand.
Less supply, the more value.
So by him having most of the supply, everybody's fucking value went up. And then they sold.
Yep.
Leaving him with nothing.
That's right.
Now, why would he do that? What's the end game? What is the end game of that, guys? I'm going to tell you why he did that. Let's go to Cobra Tate's page, brother. Brother. Come on, brother. Go down. Keep going. Wait. Okay, keep going. Keep going. Oh, wait, or was it that one?
What
did he say? I hold zero coins, I endorse zero coins, I make zero money. However, there are now hundreds and hundreds of coins associated with me. Should I make a list of which coins are gay and which coins are not gay? This is not endorsement, but it's Pride Month. We should know which gay coins. Jingo. Okay, go down. Right there. Right there. It's like that meme, Jesse. Make sure you put that meme with Leonardo DiCaprio. Tomorrow morning, when the top G awakes, he can go about his day. Fucking speaking to himself in third person. What the fuck? Or he can once again dedicate this time to setting the crypto market on fire. Time is valuable. 50,000 retweets and 3,000 new students. 3,000 new students, guys. Only then will I force the world to burn. Clearly, he's gaining students, guys, out of this. Now, why would he do that? I just told you why.
It's influence, guys.
Influence.
So
and money.
Well, think about this. If you really, really think about it, money is secondary. And that's true. It's all debt. Well, at least America's currency, right? Different countries trying to change that, going back to gold and silver. But anyways, whole nother topic. But at the end of the day, guys, what really gives anything value is people's influence. And so if you can get people, because currency is constantly changed throughout generations, centuries, right? There's always been different management of currency. And so if you have control over people's, I guess, influence or decision making, right? You can initially get them to, well,
you get them to do what you want, guys. It comes down to rhetoric.
All the time. And so that's initially what he's focusing on. For him, money is just the tool. What he's really focusing on, what really holds the value here is this. I'm going to highlight it. People. 3,000 new students. So just keep that in mind, guys. That's initially the strategy. He's damn fucking good at it. Obviously, you know, Mike and I appreciate his tactics. Again,
guys,
him and his brother are something else. They're fucking funny as hell. We may not agree with everything they say, but I appreciate who the fuck they are.
The conversation we'd have, how interesting it would be.
No shit, right?
Guys, this comes down to the most basic principle of rhetoric. And not even getting too into it, it's just starting off. I always like to use this principle. And this is how I start off my voir dires before trial. Because understand, a voir dire, I have to make sure that whoever gets on my jury of the final 12 jurors is people that I want to be hearing the case, right? And the way you do that to start off, simple way, and I start off with the acronym of RAW. Raw. You go RAW.
Go RAW, Mike.
Receptive, attentive, and well-disposed.
Ah, okay. I thought you were talking about different RAW.
Receptive, attentive, and well-disposed. Remember that. How the fuck are you going to get people to be receptive and attentive? You give them money. You give them money, and you tell them, this is all for you. I'm going to burn this money. After that, they're well-disposed because they got fucking money. And guess where they're going to keep getting more of it? Through his influence.
Yeah, that's right.
They've officially been RAW-dogged.
Entirely RAW now.
That's a little bit of art of rhetoric for you. If you want to read more about it, look into Aristotle. He has an entire book about it. It goes back to centuries, guys, thousands of years. This isn't anything new.
Damn, this is intense. Look at this one. Like, well, the caption itself, before I play this video, I don't know what this is. Oh, my God, I'm dying. Make late night TV great again. I would rather be grabbed by the
pussy
than have a
pussy
president. More of this, please. Let's see.
Bro, you're more hesitant to say that than nigga.
Because we all niggas, man. I'm kind of thinking just for a moment. Let's see what's up.
That this is the man who talked about grabbing women by the pussy. Is there any point, a part of you that feels this is not my guy? I don't want this guy to be talking like this about anyone. At all. You don't despair for the future in any way.
Sweetie, I would rather be grabbed by the pussy than have a pussy for president.
Oh, shit. Someone had to say it.
I'm very happy with that language. Look, none of us are that polite behind closed doors. My girlfriends have.
That's what we've been saying. Exactly.
The gentleman clapping is a real man, obviously. He would have ruder language than pussy. I'm not offended by the expression.
He's no longer in the locker room. He's in the Oval Office.
Sure, and that was a private conversation 8 years ago.
Stop being a bitch, bro.
Whilst Clinton was in the Oval Office, of course, Monica Lewinsky was on her knees.
Oh! Hillary
stood right by her, so I don't know if you're going to say that to anybody.
That's right.
She's not president. I'm talking about the current president-elect.
Yes, but when Bill Clinton was president.
I'm not talking about the past, I'm talking about the future.
And 8 years ago,
this guy doesn't get the message.
Looks like a liberal.
Yeah, he's clearly liberal.
I'm not offended you while you deal with your issues.
Are any of you have no issues?
He's not even a woman, and he's offended.
Exactly.
About the nature of.
No, you know, what we needed in America was someone that was going to have a strong lead, who was going to stand up for white people as well as black people in America.
That's right, equal.
For bringing jobs back. For allowing Americans to have their weapons.
That's right.
And for allowing the Supreme Court to be a conservative Supreme Court. No one here can really understand that, which is why the pollsters were wrong, why you guys were wrong.
Oh, my buddy.
And every other commentator and every other pundit.
Yeah, who is this woman?
I don't know, man, but she got some good points.
She's getting a fan.
Right?
I see you again, I'll be like, yeah, I know her. She a real motherfucker.
Hey, look, Ryan's alive, bro.
Y'all weird.
Y'all weird. Who cares
if there was an earthquake or not? Oh.
We were just talking about that. Does it really matter to you whether I was right or wrong? Who cares? There's kids dying across the whole world, and you guys get distracted by the weirdest things. All praise to Jesus.
Guys, this goes back to apparently he had made a prediction that there was going to be an earthquake in Los Angeles or Nevada and Nevada, Las Vegas on June 6th. Was there? No.
Fag breakdown for those that don't get it. What's going on here?
Trying to understand this. How is it that you boys think referring to gay people as fags in today's world is acceptable?
Because we're not referring to gay people. You can be gay and not be a fag. You're not gay.
I happen to be gay, boys. Do you think I'm a fag?
Yeah.
Do you ride a big loud Harley and go up and down the streets ruining everyone's nice time?
No.
Then you're not.
Then you're not a fag.
So what if a guy is gay and rides a Harley?
Then he's a gay fag. I mean, he's really. I don't know. All right, look, you're driving in your car, okay? And you're waiting to make a left at a traffic signal. The light turns yellow, should be your turn to go, but the traffic coming at you just keeps coming. And even when the light turns red, a guy in a BMW runs the red light so you can't make your left turn. What goes through your mind?
Fag.
Right. But you're not thinking, oh, he's a homosexual. You're thinking, oh, he's an inconsiderate douchebag like a Harley rider.
Exactly. It's like when we say, don't be a little bitch.
Making insanely good sense. Trying to understand this.
This is making insanely good sense. Fuck, man. It's spot on, though.
Look, there's a fag. I mean,
what a fag. I mean, what a bitch.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. Is this what you were talking about?
Yeah, look at that shit. Look.
Hey, right here. Mid-pause.
Right there. That's when he shit himself.
In spite of the millions of people watching, this elderly fool is sliding a Biden right there on stage.
Oh, man.
As the jackass fills his tighty-whities with Bidenomics.
Clearly, it's a fucking meme. So he just never sat down.
No.
Bro, it's become a real thing. Look at
well,
this
I
shit.
I think he ended up sitting down, but wait.
RNT.
Will be listed.
What the fuck, bro? The power of influence, man.
The power of influence, dude. He just got himself... Oh... That was fake footage. I saw that.
What's
this? Hunter Biden.
This?
Yeah.
It's fake?
Well, that's what they say. Apparently, they're saying that it's Hunter Biden because of the tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
Hunter has similar tattoos on his back. And that's someone that's what looks like they're dragging a woman, whether she's a prostitute or whatever, I don't know. But he's dragging a woman back into the hotel room. And you see those tattoos on the back? Supposedly that's the same tattoos that Hunter had, but they're not.
Man, it looks like a Chinese dude, bro.
Yeah, yeah. Like, it's not the same dude, but a lot of people, that footage has been circulating saying that it is.
Yeah, it don't look like him. I mean, I'm not a Biden fan, but that doesn't look like
him.
Yeah,
like, we deal with facts. We're not going to pull the same fucking card as other people would.
So apparently this is Ryan Garcia. Because that's when they took him in.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
You're going pretty fast, bro.
That's my bad. Let's see. Coins again.
A potential poison jury?
Court has just notified Judge Juan Mershon that someone identifying themselves as the cousin of one of the jurors posted to the court's Facebook page that Trump was going to be found guilty.
Before the announcement?
This happened.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Before the verdict was announced. We're working to verify all this information and what it means about Trump's case. Folks, major breaking news on the Trump.
So,
we'll go for it.
So we were actually looking into that, remember?
Yeah, we were.
We said, hey, let's look into see what we find out. And, you know, I started getting into the whole cultural issues in 2024 and stuff like that. But, you know, Mike and I actually did a deep dive on that. We were looking through the New York court's Facebook page, and apparently this happened on May 29th. So we looked down... I believe it was this post specifically. It might have been this one. Yeah, right?
Yeah, I think it was that one.
Apparently, they took it down, and I think everybody was looking for it. So
they took down the post right there.
Right,
the
right here, look. They took
I don't
down.
Think that's legal. Certainly not ethical. Okay, not okay. It's not illegal to take a post down.
Nah. Trump lawyers are going to have a field day with us. God bless them. I want to see this. I'm just here for the Facebook comments. Cricket court system. So, to be exact, guys, what we're talking about is this. So, it says, Dear Counsel, today the court became aware of a comment that was posted on Unified Court System public Facebook page, in which I now bring to your attention. So, this is the judge initially sending to the parties of this case. In the comment, the user Michael Anderson states, My cousin is a juror and says, Trump is getting convicted. Thank you, folks, for all your hard work. The comment, now labeled as 1 week old, responded to routine UCS notice posted on May 29th. Regarding our arguments in the Fourth Department of the Appellate Division and related to this proceeding, the posting entitled The Appellate Division Fourth Department will hear oral
arguments this morning
at 10. Yeah.
On a totally unrelated post. And some guy,
and the comments
I guess it was related
viewable.
To Trump, but not really. And they're like, well, good job, my, you know, good job system. They're convicting Trump.
What are your thoughts there, bro?
Well, The problem that I have, if you go back to the video that you were just playing with the guy, is...
And
replay like 10 seconds before.
Before?
Oh, no, right there.
Has just notified, or the New York Supreme Court has just notified Judge Juan Merchan.
Hold on, keep going.
That someone identifying themselves as the cousin of one of the jurors posted to the court's Facebook page that Trump was going to be found guilty. This happened one day before the verdict was announced. We're working to verify information and what it means.
Working to verify.
The problem is, if you have such a big news studio that has the weight of credibility behind it already, it's your job to have already verified that.
That is
just jumping on a story.
Well, that's the thing. That's normal practice for media outlets nowadays.
It is, and it's horrible. It's not real journalism.
Not anymore.
Back then, they would have, when you post something, it would have already been verified, and it would have given you detailed sources as to, you know, at least those that wouldn't be compromised, right? But it would give you that, this is source backed, this is good.
Well, they'd actually have a point of reference. They would have more than likely already gotten in contact with the person that put that comment up and then verified whether or not they actually are related and then gotten some info as why they made that comment to begin with.
This is the equivalent of someone going on social media and saying, hey, this guy stole this. I haven't verified it, but...
Hey, this guy here is racist.
Yeah.
Attack his ass. Yeah.
Like, that is what's the problem with the legacy media nowadays, guys.
It's not the same anymore, ladies and gents.
In a nutshell. Right fucking there.
But all right, man. I think we had enough... A good amount of cruising the X today.
Yeah, we have
some good little things here.
Shit just pisses me off.
Calm down, Mike. Calm down.
Nah, I'm not pissed, guys. Honestly.
But look. There is hope for society, okay? Or for the human race.
I think that is a concluding of the episode, guys. There's not much topics to go over, at least that interests us at this point. And enough for us to talk about it with y'all. We're kind of waiting for other things to play out. Obviously, the Trump sentencing is going to be on July 11th. But maybe this changes the game. What happened with the juror? Who knows about that? Ryan Garcia fulfilling his own prophecies. Stogies and stuff out. But if I talk about God, my record won't get played, huh? Well, if this take away from my spin.